Gotcha. The master of all I survey, that's me. So quiet, I never get used to that. All the sounds I took for granted, cars honking, bacon sizzling on a griddle, children crying, nails on a chalkboard, a phone ringing, other voices. I've forgotten what they all sound like. I think I know, but I'm not sure. But they're almost like ghosts. Phantom reminders of a life long gone. Sometimes it's hard for me to believe there even was a life before the existence I now know, that any of it was real, because the only reality I know is this. The daily tedium. The endless journey across an unchanging tableau. With the occasional side trip into Paphos, courtesy of my neighbors. But the neighbors have been quiet lately. Perhaps I'll be able to end my day in peace. That would be nice. Every so often, I speak my name aloud just to see what it sounds like. If I'm really ambitious, I'll even say a few sentences just to give the vidbot something different to record.
The sky glowed green today at sunset.
It does that often these days, and I can sit and watch it for hours. Because when it vanishes and darkness falls upon me, it's still embedded in my mind. My name is Bruce Banner. I am over 200 years old, I think. I feel cold. And I should be dying very soon. I want to. God in heaven, I want to. But he won't let me. He never feels cold. Or love. Or anything. Except anger.
Banner. Puny Banner. Still feel him rattling around in Hulk's head. Was out for a while. Doing stupid, puny human things. Why won't Banner leave Hulk alone? Why does Banner still stay with Hulk, no matter what?
Doesn't Banner know that Hulk hates him?
More than anyone. More than leader. More than abomination. Hulk hates Banner. And Hulk hates that little floating thing. Hulk would smash it. If Hulk could catch it. And Bugs. Hulk hates Bugs. But Banner, most of all.
They called World War I the big one. The war to end all wars. The irony of that was, of course, that they had no idea what was awaiting them. World War II ushered in the atomic age. When Truman dropped the bombs on Hiroshima and Nagasaki, it was a rather spectacular bluff. The U.S. only had two bombs, Fat Man and Little Boy. It would have taken months to produce more. Months during which, for all we know, the Japanese could have mounted a counteroffensive. But instead, the Japanese saw the terrible might at the disposal of their opponents and surrendered. They knew, I suspect, the horrible thing that had been unleashed and hoped that it would never again see the light of day. One might argue that their surrender was honorable. There is no honor left in the world. There is no world. I haven't traveled the entire world, you understand. Just my part of it. Enough to satisfy me. I have traveled the length and breadth of the United States, explored the entire North American continent. Up into Canada, down into Mexico, past leveled mountains and destroyed monuments, down into South America, where riverbeds were long dried, and the remains of the rainforest were wilted and dying. I lived in Vegas for a time. Or, more accurately, the Hulk did, posing under the guise of Mr. Fix-It. He operated as a leg breaker at a casino. For a time, it seemed that my life was filled with nothing but change. Yet the more I changed, the more I stayed the same. Now nothing changes. I used to wear foot coverings, but my feet became so hard and calloused that a nail gun couldn't penetrate my soles by now. I still have a pronounced limp from the leg break that never healed properly. I need no protection from the sun, for the haze hangs in the air as a shield. As the only man in the world, I needn't worry about clothes. But a shred of remaining propriety prompts minimal clothing. I also shave every few days, just so I don't have the maestro's face staring back at me should I catch a passing reflection. There's still traces of radiation in the air, but it never bothers me particularly. My molecular structure, even in its human form, is just a sponge for it now, has been for years. My poor body may be heir to the other frailties of humanity, but from raids, raids at least, I remain immune. I would have died long ago of starvation were it not for his ability to ingest virtually anything and turn it into pure energy. Not since the shark has there been such a perfect engine of survival. I am the weak piston in that engine. I tremble a good deal these days. Might be Parkinson's, might just be nerves. And then, suddenly, the rest of me is shaking, not just the hands, but my legs, and even the ground. That's when I realize they're after me. I always know when they are, because the ground trembles beneath their feet as they approach, moving in mass like a black undulating carpet. And the Hulk isn't coming. Instead, he hides somewhere within me, reveling in my weakness. Perhaps he wants to hear me beg. I don't want to beg. I want to die. But I fight to live. Out of old habit. The ground is nearly as brittle as I am. Flat and dry and inhospitable to most any sort of life. Nevertheless, I start to run. I don't glance back. Because I know the black wave is coming. The vidbot floats behind me, leisurely taking it all in. If I survive, then I'll be interested in watching the outcome. If not, well, so much the better. Then I hear something, like a rustling of plastic wings clicking against hollow bodies. Now I do glance back, and I see them coming. But they're not skittering along. Oh, no. Not at all. They're flying. The bastards are flying now. Scientists said that the only thing that would likely be around after it all came to an end would be the cockroaches. From an evolutionary standpoint, they were the ideal survivors. Did they have to be this damned correct? In the past, when they attacked the Hulk, it was always by surprise, when he was sleeping or something like that. Now there's no escaping them, asleep or awake. Banner or Hulk. They swarm towards me. How ludicrous I must appear. Running faster and faster across the scorched plain, my skinny arms pumping, my feet thwapping on the parched ground. Then I feel something go in my calf, a muscle spasm, but at my age, that's all it takes. I go down hard. and I can practically hear the brittle snapping of the bones. I roll on the ground, but I don't feel the agony that must be there. Maybe I'm in shock.
Get up!
My mind screams. And it's not my voice doing so, but his. My breath is ragged in my chest. I don't know whether it's my imagination or whether they're really making some sort of swarming noise, like locusts and chittering. Oh God, they've almost caught up with me. They're coming, and I can feel the change. And he's coming. And I'm going to live. Damn him. Damn him to hell.
Bugs everywhere. Bugs attacking Hulk. What to hurt Hulk? People all gone, and still, Hulk is not left alone. Bugs all over Hulk. Hulk pushes them off, crushes them. Hulk's fingers are thick with crushed bugs. But Hulk crushes 10, and 100 more come. They rip at Hulk's skin. Hulk is strongest one there is. Millions, millions of bugs everywhere. They would have killed Puny Banner. They're trying to kill Hulk. Nothing can stop Hulk. Nothing can hurt Hulk. But they are hurting Hulk everywhere. Arms, legs, crawling all over. Why would they leave Hulk alone?
Holy Mother of God. And I watch the playback on the vidbot and still can't quite believe it. Lord knows, I've seen it before. But it still staggers credibility. I remember, centuries ago, when that super tanker spilled oil all over the coast of Alaska. And there were pictures of animals. Poor, helpless animals covered with oil. I felt so sorry for the unfortunate beasts. Well, that's what the Hulk looks like in the playback. Except that the oil slick is alive. I watch him roar and howl and shout things in almost inarticulate fury. Watch as he's consumed by them. Given any single foe, or even any group of foes, and the Hulk was always able to triumph. But trying to beat back a bug attack is like trying to fight the surf. For all the good it does you to battle it, you might as well not try at all. Credit the Hulk, he does try. He fights, he squirms, he howls. Wow. And eventually, the bugs grow tired or sated or bored, whatever. Just as they always do, the attack ceases. The bugs depart. You'd think I'd be used to it by now. That I'd be able to look at the remains of a bug attack on the Hulk with clinical dispassion. I always believe that, right before my stomach wrenches. The Hulk's stomach might react the same way. If he still had a stomach, that is. He's barely recognizable as anything even remotely humanoid. They've stripped away his skin, chewed up his musculature, gotten partway into his circulatory system. As near as I can tell, one of his kidneys has been eaten away, and roughly a yard of his lower intestine. Both eyes are gone, and his tongue as well. I can tell because he's not saying any words at this point, merely running unintelligibly. This looks like a bad one. It's gonna take him a while to recover. At least the bugs have no taste for inanimate matter. Or I'd always need to find new outfits after an attack. So, Vidbot, give me a real-time elapse count on my mark, please. And mark. The science, the art of discovery. The thrill of observing an amazing process. and then reporting your findings to your peers, accepting their accolades. Except the only peers I ever had wore gaudy, skin-tight costumes, and most of them wouldn't have understood even the simplest of formulae that I could have shared with them. I'm sure there were exceptions, yeah, like Tony and Reed. But most of them wouldn't have known an accolade from a Gatorade, anyway. They're long gone now. Time check, 2 minutes. The Hulk has managed the following repairs. The skin is re-knitting itself onto the skeleton. His tongue has grown back in. The steady stream of invective about the world in general and me in particular was the tip-off of that little development. Time check, 11 minutes. His eyes have just grown back in. Curious that the eyes always take so long, perhaps because the eyes are the window to the soul and the Hulk is a soulless monster. Science and philosophy, a dangerous mix. All right, 17 minutes just before the lining of his belly was restored. I saw his intestines reinserting themselves, his healing processes. Almost like watching a film of a disemboweling being run backwards. Quote 18 minutes, he's fully healed. And he's not in a good mood. He snarls something that I can't quite make out, and then he leaps for it, just as he has done so many times in the past. But the device is elegant in its simplicity. Capable of detecting any motion coming its way and keeping a distance of 10 feet between itself and harm. Solar-powered, it would take nothing less than the destruction of the entire world to put an end to the vidbot. And for all I know, even Armageddon might not be enough to finish the Hulk.
Hulk hates stupid floating globe. Hulk hates puny banner. Hulk hates stupid bugs. And Hulk hates how much it hurts when Hulk's body regrows. Hulk hates world. But at least Hulk's enemies are gone. Stupid men, stupid women, always trying to hurt Hulk. And stupid boy, Rick, is gone. And Betty is gone. Her father, the shouting man, is gone. All gone, all gone, all gone. And Hulk is still here. Hulk had last laugh, and Hulk will keep laughing, because Hulk is strongest one there is.
I'll be damned. It's still here. When the government proposed the Costume Adventurers Memorial Park, after all the casualties during the Hell on Earth War, I never thought it would happen, much less last. But it did. They're all laid to rest here. Those who fell during Hell on Earth, and then those in the Outer World War. Even those who just went from old age. All here. All gone. And none of them lived to see. After everything they went through to protect humanity from alien enemies, from evil forces who wanted to eliminate or enslave mankind. None of them lived to see mankind fall before the one enemy humans were helpless before. Other humans. But he saw. Not only that, but he derived a sort of grim satisfaction from it. As if seeing mankind destroy itself was some sort of validation for the opinion he'd held for so long. The Hulk didn't care that the initial bombings were terrorists acting outside government mandates. He didn't care about millions upon millions of innocent people dying. He didn't care that the remaining heroes, the defenders of mankind, died in those blasts. Just as did their villainous opponents, because nuclear holocaust doesn't care about good guys and bad guys. He cared about two things, and two things only. About being the strongest one there is. And about being left alone. It never struck the Hulk as unusual that others died of old age. Well, he kept going. Somehow, to him, It seemed right. It was his healing ability, of course, which repaired damage to his body at an accelerated rate, and to mine, albeit somewhat more slowly, and far less efficiently. And all the radiation being released from the last war, why, it made him all the stronger. But he didn't care about all that either, though. The noise of the explosions, though, and the cries of the dead, and the dying. Those things bothered him. Whether they offended his sense of order, or jabbed his conscience, or just served as an annoyance, I really couldn't say. All I know is that he wanted to distance himself from it. So as he had so many times before, he returned to New Mexico, the place of his birth. The Gamma Cave. He sealed us in, and there we stayed until all the shouting died down. Not using much energy, and so not requiring much in the way of sustenance. There was a natural spring running through the cave, although I suspect it was contaminated by radiation. Not that that bothered the Hulk, of course. Although it, along with the free-floating rads, had a slow, visible effect on him. And then, one day...
So, my readings were correct. A human has survived. How inconvenient.
Inconvenient? What are you talking about?
I am a recorder. My base is in the Rigel section. I have been here for some time at the request of a number of races, recording the demise of humanity.
Recording our demise? Why? Do other races want to learn from our mistakes?
No, they just want to make sure you're all dead.
All dead?
Most sentient beings consider yours a most troublesome race. You will not be missed, I am told. The Kree and Skrulls have actually formed an alliance for the purpose of sponsoring a celebration. It should be quite festive.
All dead?
Are you aware that you're repeating yourself?
All?
Yes.
I'm the only human alive.
That would be implicit in the part about everyone else being dead, yes.
This isn't some kind of joke!
I know, I wasn't laughing.
So, are you going to kill me? To make sure?
Do you want me to? Do you wish to die?
No!
You'll change your mind. But your desires on that score are irrelevant, for genocide is outside my function. I merely record. However, my continued presence is not necessary as of this point. Indeed, it might affect the events from here on, and that would be inappropriate. So instead, I will be leaving this vidbot. It will record on my behalf. When it registers your demise, I will retrieve it.
Wait! They can't all be dead. There must be something I can do.
As a matter of fact, there is.
What? What is it?
If you should happen to address the vidbot, please enunciate. Your species has... I'm sorry, had... a tendency to mumble. Farewell.
And just like that, I was alone. He was right, though. I did have to watch my diction. When you're without anyone to talk to, conversational skills tend to erode. Oh, and he was right about something else. I changed my mind. I don't know what possessed me. It was a waste of time. I should have known. I should have known he'd stop it. I tried to do it without warning him. Not think about it. Just do it.
I hate him. Hate puny bitter. Tried to kill himself. Stupid Banner. He thinks he can kill Hulk. He thinks he can get away. But Hulk will live on forever. Hulk is strongest one.
She's beautiful,
standing at the far end of a plateau. She's breathtaking. Look at her. She's naked, clothed in flowing brown hair. She looks happy to see me. My God, I can't remember the last time I looked at anyone who was happy to see me, much less a beautiful naked woman. She's not approaching me. It could be a trap of some sort. No. No, it's not. And even if it is, why should I give a damn at this late date? Every step I take towards her, her beauty seems to grow and blossom and become more pure, more luscious, like an overripe fruit begging to be devoured. My decrepit state, my appearance, none of it seems to bother her. She wants me. She needs me. Pure green grass is blooming beneath her feet, and the horizon is now the purest blue. And as I draw closer and closer, I feel younger, more buoyant, more alive. And then I'm upon her. And everywhere I am, so is she. And I feel heat building within me. And then she whispers in my ear, "We'll be gods. Gods. Gods!" The woman, gone. The green grass, gone. The blue sky, all vanishing into the twilight mist of unreality. But the heat is still here. I feel it. The heat in my chest. Dull, constricting like a vice. Like fire. Fire. Gods. Of course. Of course. I understand now. I've been blind. How could I have been so blind? Banner! What is puny Banner doing? Banner is trying to hurt Hulk. Something is going on with Banner. Never should have kept puny Banner around. Don't know why. Why Hulk did. Stupid. Hulk is strongest, but not smartest. Hulk never needed to be smart. Smart is puny Banner weak. Banner don't want to be smart like Banner. Don't want to be anything like Banner. Hulk won't let him hurt Hulk anymore. Why did Hulk let him stay? Hulk must crush him. Like bug.
I've been feeling pain on and off for 2 days. Didn't think anything of it. But now. Now it's growing. Perhaps the Hulk's body can go on forever. But this one can't. The grip of fire across my chest, and I've realized it. It all makes sense now. In Greek mythology, Prometheus, the legendary Titan, created mankind from the clay. But Prometheus felt that Zeus, king of the gods, hurler of lightning bolts, treated his creation badly. So, to make up for it, Prometheus introduced humanity to fire. Fire, from which flowed man's technology and scientific advancement. Furious over the Titans' actions, the gods punished mankind by unleashing the evils of Pandora's box. As for Prometheus, they chained him to a mountain peak in the Caucasus, there to be endlessly devoured by carrion eaters. His innards plucked out, his flesh torn away. Prometheus left to writhe in agony as they consumed him bit by bit.
Banner! Thinking too much. Puny Banner must stop him.
And whatever was eaten would always grow back. His body would heal itself good as new, so that the process could begin all over again. And the Hulk?
Hulk smash!
The Hulk is the living embodiment of the Atomic Age. The Atomic Age Frankenstein, they called him. The Atomic Age Jekyll and Hyde. The Atomic Age, which brought fire and a terrible, terrible knowledge to mankind. A knowledge for which the final, terrible price was oblivion. When the Hulk first strode the Earth, God in heaven, there were giants in those days. Thor and Hercules and Giant Man and Captain America and the Fantastic Four and Spider-Man. And all of them, on and on. More than mortal, they were each, in their way, titans. Some of them, like the X-Men, even owed their existence on a genetic level to radiation.
Shut up, Banner! Stop your puny talking! Stop making chest hurt! What is Banner's plan? Yes, Banner is trying to hurt Hulk, to destroy Hulk. One final time. But Hulk will stop him.
There were giants in those days, but they're all gone now. Gone. Along with mankind. Gone. Because of the ghastly knowledge that came from the creation of the atomic bomb. But the Hulk was spawned in the heart of a nuclear blast. That made him first. First among the Titans. First. And last. Someone has to pay for that knowledge. Someone has to continue to be punished. Because there are crimes that are simply so awful, so beyond forgiveness, that punishment must continue to be exacted. That is what hell is for, after all. Hell on Earth. The Hulk is heir to Prometheus, the living symbol of nuclear fire, to be devoured over and over again, but always able to rise up and be consumed once more. The last Titan. But Prometheus was eventually shown mercy. Freed. And now, I'm being given that same chance at mercy. Because my body is failing. And if he lets me go, it'll be over. The suffering, our suffering, will finally be over.
Banner. 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 Trying to trick Hulk. Hulk will change. Hulk will come out. Will.
It's so perfect. The fire in my chest is building. Building like a lover. Can't move. They're there. I can see them.
just ahead. I thought I'd forgotten them, but no, they're just as I remembered. Every line of their faces, every curve of their bodies. Betty, Rick, Marlo. My God, Jim Wilson and
Jarella, you're there.
And Mom.
I never thought I'd see you.
All of you. Hulk, let it go.
Let me go. Look at them.
Hulk sees nothing. Nothing except stupid trick by puny Banner. Hulk will come out now. Stop pain and chest. Stop.
Hulk, don't. Please. I'm almost there.
You can come with me. It will be wonderful. All your friends will be there. And there will be peace. There will be peace.
Please.
Hulk doesn't want friends.
Hulk, God in heaven, listen to me.
No! For years, forever, Hulk has listened to Banner and Banner's friends talking about how Hulk ruined Banner's life. Hulk made Banner's life. Banner was nothing before Hulk. Nothing.
It'll be different, Hulk. You'll have peace. Friends.
Hulk doesn't want friends because friends will hurt him. Everyone hurts him. Everyone hurts Hulk.
Hulk, for once, see the world without anger. See not what is, but what could be. See the place where we could see this place of peace. Hulk, just can't think. Hulk, don't do it. Let me go, please. Please.
No! Hulk won't let it happen. Hulk doesn't want friends. Hulk doesn't want to be with anybody because Hulk just wants to be left alone! Banner. Banner. Is gone now. Got rid of him last night. Banner tried to make Hulk die. But Hulk was too smart. Hulk was too strong. Hulk will never let Banner come back. Because if Hulk ever dies, then Hulk will die. And Hulk does not ever want to die. Not ever. Because then everyone who kept trying to kill Hulk will win. And Hulk can't ever let them win, even though they are gone. Hulk must still win. Hulk must never lose. Hulk will even find a way to beat Bucks someday. And Hulk doesn't miss Banner at all. Hulk is happy to be alone. Yes, Hulk is happy. Hulk never needed Banner, never needed any of them, because if Hulk needed someone, then Hulk would be weak. And Hulk must never be weak. Never. Because Hulk is strongest one there is. Hulk is only one there is. Only one.